Here's the chicken. It is a whole chicken. I put some wax paper down, as you see, to minimize the cleanup. I know we're going to have some. What I'm doing now, around the mouth of the chicken, which is, by the legs, is the opening of the chicken, okay? You see this? Here's the tail. Here's the head. Here's the wings. Here's the breast. What you do is we're going to reach inside and we're going to clean it out. So when you reach inside, you get guts. It's no big deal. We're going to rinse it out with cold water really, really good, okay? And when you do that, you're really cleaning out all the insides, okay? You see all that blood and things? We're going to eliminate that. But you want to really run water down the mouth and make sure it comes out the other side. When you run water down the mouth, you can see things like guts and things in there. Just scrape it out. Just scrape it out. You can use just your finger and scrape it like this, or you can scrape it like this. You just fill in bones and you'll feel removable stuff like pieces of fat. It is nothing, you guys. But you don't want to cook it in your chicken. You want your chicken to be as clean as possible. You're going to have fat around the edges. See that? That's going to be around the lips of the chicken, of the opening, the largest openings. Actually, there's two openings. There's a little opening here, as you can see. But the largest one is what you can fit your hand down in and what you can really clean the cavity of the chicken. Okay? Now, I'm showing you that in case you want to keep it whole, but I'm going to show you what I do when I'm not trying to stuff it with something, okay? I'm going to move this out the way. I have a bag in this sink if you're wondering why I'm doing that. I'm going to take a paper towel and clean up as much as I can, because you know we're going to wipe this off with bleach and soap. Let me rinse my hands a little bit. Whenever you go to touch something and you're messing with chicken, make sure you wipe your hands off. Rinse off the chicken, whatever, and wipe your hands off before you go to touch something. Like, I'm getting ready to get wax paper, more wax paper. So I want to make sure that I don't have any chicken blood on my hand. You can contaminate. If you touch a raw chicken and then, let's say, put your hand on your coffee pot, and then, let's say, you touch some clean dishes, well, that's bacteria that you're leaving on those dishes, and you will make somebody very, very sick. So whenever you're dealing with chicken, try to keep it in one spot and keep yourself clean and sanitized as much as you can, because it's very important, okay? Once the chicken is cooked, it's okay. But when the chicken is not cooked and it's raw and you're messing with blood, and really that's any kind of blood, beef, pork, fish, don't make no difference, you keep your hands clean and stay in the spot until you're done dealing with that raw flesh. Anytime you're dealing with flesh, you keep your hands clean. Okay, now what I do, this is the back, the tail, like I told you before, of the chicken. So it's easier if you start at the neck, and I'm going to cut down one side of the neck. You see that? It'll open up. And if you find yourself hitting the bone, just move over a little bit and go a little further, because you're right there at the thigh. See that? You're right there at the thigh. So if you find yourself running into a part where you can't go any further, just feel around and then you'll know where to cut. You'll feel the opening of the bone joint where they connect, and then you'll know to cut there, okay? Take your time. Remember what I said, nobody's in no hurry. There it go. Nobody's in a hurry, okay? And just feel around for that joint. There it is. Okay? And just finish cutting right on up. There. Now, you did that side. See how it's open now? See that? Now, you want to do the other side. You want to get that neck off. And you just use that neck and use that bone as your guide, because you don't want that bone anyway. Okay, now I have this chicken fat tied up. It's ready for the garbage. Next, we're going to put a cap of bleach into our dishwater. There we know we're killing any germs. We're going to take that bottle of soap we touched, rinse it off in there, Now it's sanitized again. We're going to take a dish towel and we're just going to run the dish towel, soap and water, all over where we touch. We touch the sink, we touch the nozzle. We're going to run it all over there very carefully. We don't want to splash it on our chicken. We're going to run it over our knives that we use before we place them in the sink to wash them, okay? Not after, before. Remember what I said, you want to be really careful about dealing with flesh. Anytime you're dealing with meat, you make sure you clean everything you touched. Okay? So the first thing you do is put your hands in the soapy water. Then you get the bleach. Then you drop your bleach in there. And then you start cleaning. Now I'm going to clean the surface. I know I'm not done with the chicken yet. But I want that surface clean. And that's less I have to worry about when I'm done with the chicken. Okay? Now, once again, I'm back sanitized. Wax paper. You don't have to use wax paper like this, you guys. You can really just use your counter. But what I want to stress to you is that you keep it clean and that you keep your counter free of all germs, okay? So now we have our chicken. We're going to turn it over. Flesh side up. Remember, you keep everything tight so when you go to rinse off, you know what you have to clean, okay? So we got the flesh side up. We're going to season it. Salt, pepper, garlic on both sides, okay? Here we have pepper. We're going to do pepper on one side. Here's our salt and our garlic. We're going to do it on one side really well because you're talking about a whole chicken this time, okay? You don't want to overdo it, but you want to make sure you cover it with the seasoning so that you see it with your eye. I want you new cookers to get eye for looking at your seasoning, and once you sprinkle it, you see it. You don't have to cover it. You just have to see it, okay? Now, we're going to turn it over. As a matter of fact, let's do this. I have a pan, a glass Pyrex dish with foil, lined with foil, and I did oil it lightly so the chicken won't stick. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place the chicken in there. Now, we're going to move this wax paper out the way. We're going to get our towel, wipe up where we were. Once again, we're going to go over that nozzle that we touched, okay? Now, let me show you this. Let me rinse my hands off and make sure I don't have any soap or bleach on my hands. Your chicken, you're going to lay it down. You're going to make sure your wings are on the side, and you're going to make sure your legs are tucked, okay? So when you get through, and I'll make sure you have pictures, your chicken should look like this. You see it? Almost like a person. Your legs are tucked. Your wings are on the side. You see that? And I'll make sure I have a good picture for you. Now, you're going to season the top of it. Like I say, ladies, you want to see your seasoning. You don't want to overdo it. You just want to see it. Some butter, drizzle it on top. I'm going to take a picture so you can see it, and your chicken is now ready for the oven. We're done seasoning, have everything on top of our chicken. Always make a little tent when you're putting meat in the oven. I know that helps the heat distribute better, but it really makes a nice skin and a nice browning. We're going to put it in the oven. I've preheated the oven to 425. I'm going to put on there 35 minutes. After 35 minutes, I'll then take the top off and 10 minutes more for the browning, okay? And I know the chicken will be done.
How I tell if the chicken is done, I run my two fingers under cold water and I squeeze the leg. If the leg goes in really easy, I don't see any blood squirting out, I know that chicken is done, okay? I'll do it for you when I think it's done. But all I'm doing now, you see how on top, it's not really touching the chicken, it's above it. That's the tin I was talking about. As long as it's closed, the heat will stay in and it'll cook very evenly and very well. Once again, 425 degrees. Set your timer for 35 minutes and then then we're going to take it out, take the top off, and put it back in for 10 more minutes to brown. One of the things I have issues with is which rack. Should I use the top rack, the bottom rack? What I do is I set my racks. You have one section on the bottom. I set the bottom one a rung above that. And then I have a rung in between my next rack. And then I slide that one in. Most of the time I cook on the top rung because I always have a problem with scorching the bottom of things. So that's my way of making sure I don't burn anything. And I always, always keep check. Just because I tell you 35 minutes, you can check in 25 because your oven cooks different from mine. And then just check until you get used to it and comfortable with what your oven does. That's what makes a good cook. She knows her equipment. I've had my oven for years and I know it like the back of my hand. So just make sure you're comfortable with your oven, okay?